Hello, my name is Kyle. I'm a technical support engineer for AGI. And today, I'm here to talk to you about a new capability coming to the chain object in SDK 1210. For those who are unfamiliar with the chain object, it allows users to compute access between multiple objects, whether that is from a single object to a group of objects, a group of objects to another group of objects, or multiple objects in series, such as going from object A to object B to object C. SDK 12.8, the chain object was revamped to expand upon these multi-hop capabilities, also introduced a new capability called optimal strands. The optimal strands allowed users to determine which strand best meets a given defined metric at each given time step. Some examples on what was available would be the distance or the processing delay, or even the scalar calculation, which allowed users to define their own metric. In SDK 12.10, we're adding to that list by adding a duration optimal metric for users to use. This allows users to be able to solve for the longest or shortest available strand at each given time step. To demonstrate the logic in action, here's a simple scenario where we have a ground station and three aircraft passing overhead, where each aircraft has a different availability interval for the ground station to see it. If we were to go down to the timeline view, our first aircraft would be signified as our optimal strand since it's the only strand available. The optimal strand will then latch onto that first aircraft until it loses access. So we'll see the optimal strand follow the first aircraft until the 17th hour, where it will then need to recompute to one of the following two aircraft. The way that we'll select from multiple accesses is finding the one that has the longest remaining access. So, for instance, the third aircraft. What's worth pointing out here is the second aircraft, where despite having the longest access total interval of an hour and a half, it is never selected as an optimal strand in terms of duration. See this in action. If we were to play out the scenario, we can see that the first aircraft in pink is the optimal strand shown with the green line. The second aircraft in yellow will never have a green line pointed to it. Instead, the green line will switch from the pink aircraft to the red, which is that third aircraft, to hold on to the green line until the end of this area. To define this optimal strand metric, you can right-click on your chain object and go to properties and navigate up to the optimal strand page, where here is that new duration option for users to use. To toggle between whether you want to do the maximum duration or the minimum, you can use the drop down here. And then, like all other optimal strand metrics, you can define the sampling time step as well as the number of samples to store. If you were to increase the number of strands to store, the logic will work a little differently due to multiple strands being needed to be considered. To demonstrate this, we have a second example where there's a MEO constellation of satellites relaying a signal from an uplink station to a downlink station. The line in green will be the best strand, the yellow will be the second best, and the red will be the third best. If we were to play this scenario out over time, the way that the optimal strand is recomputed here is whenever one of the strands loses access, it needs to recompute, but will also force all strands below it to recompute as well. So, for instance, the yellow strand, which is the second best, loses access. It will have itself recompute, but the third best strand, which is the red one, will recompute as well as the fourth best, the fifth best, the sixth best, if applicable. Thus, if you ever see the green strand need recompute, you'll see all colors change simultaneously. Some use cases for this optimal strand analysis will include things such as which target has the longest access with each pass, determining which multi-hop path minimizes the number of reroutes, and then also exposing which objects fail to contribute significant coverage over a certain area. That about sums up the new chain capability. If you have any further questions on it, you can either contact our support team at support@agi.com or go to our help page at agi.com. Thank you.